Welcome to this brief guide on adjusting spacing in Microsoft Word. Ever found yourself hitting the Enter key twice or maybe even three times just to get some space between your paragraphs? You're not alone. Many people use this method, but it can lead to some frustrating problems. The spacing can end up looking inconsistent, especially if you're using different fonts or font sizes. And if you ever need to change the spacing throughout your document, you'll then have to go back and delete all those extra enters. What a pain. But don't worry, there's a better way. In this video, we're going to ditch those extra enter keys and explore the powerful world of paragraph spacing in Microsoft Word. Let's go ahead and start with the spacing after feature. This is where you gain precise control over the vertical space that appears after each paragraph. This space is measured in what we call points. A point is a typographic unit of measurement. The higher the number, the more space you'll get after your paragraph. Okay, let's now try it out. First, we need to select the paragraph that we want to adjust. You can simply click anywhere within the paragraph to select it. Or, if you want to change the spacing for multiple paragraphs, click and drag your mouse over them to select them all. Now, right-click anywhere within the selected text. A menu will pop up with a bunch of options. See this one here that says paragraph? That's the one we want. Go ahead and click on paragraph and a new window appears. This is the paragraph dialog box. This box has a whole bunch of settings for controlling how your paragraphs look, but we're specifically interested in the spacing section. And here it is, after. Let's add some space after this paragraph. We can simply type something like 18 in the after box. This means we'll add 18 points of space after this paragraph. Now before we click OK, notice that there's also a preview section at the bottom of this window. This gives you a little sneak peek of what your changes are going to look like. Pretty handy, right? Okay, now everything looks good, so let's click OK. And there you have it. See how we've added a nice amount of space after that paragraph? No more hitting enter a bunch of times. Now, why is this so useful? Well, imagine you're writing a formal report. You might want a bit more space between the paragraphs to make it easier to read. See how this space here improves the readability? On the other hand, if you're drafting up something like an email, you might prefer less spacing to keep things concise and to the point. So, as you can see, the spacing after feature gives you the flexibility to adjust the spacing to suit just about any type of document. Okay, now let's take a look at the spacing before option. This works in a similar way to spacing after, but instead of adding space after the paragraph, you guessed it, it adds space before the paragraph begins. This is really useful for creating visual separation between different elements in your document. For example, you might want to add some extra space before a heading to make it stand out more. So, let's select this heading here. Right-click, go to paragraph, and now let's add a value in the before box. Let's try 24 this time. Click OK, and there we go. See how that heading now has some breathing room above it? It really makes it pop, doesn't it? You can use spacing before to separate headings from body text, like we just did, or to create clear divisions between different sections in a longer document. It can also be used to add extra emphasis to a particular paragraph, like this. Just add a bit of spacing before to make it stand out from the surrounding text. Now, let's move on to line spacing. This controls the amount of space between the lines within a paragraph. So instead of adjusting the space between paragraphs, we're now going to be adjusting the space between the lines themselves. Again, we'll go to our trusty paragraph settings. This time, we're focusing on this drop-down menu that's labeled line spacing. Click on the drop-down arrow and you'll see a bunch of options. Single spacing means there's minimal space between the lines, which is good when you want to fit a lot of text into a small space. 1.5 lines adds a bit more space, making it a little bit easier on the eyes. This is a popular choice for things like letters and reports. Double spacing adds even more space, which is often used in academic papers to allow room for comments and edits. And then there's exactly. This lets you specify the exact point value for the line spacing, giving you even more precise control. So if you want something between single and 1.5 spacing, you can use exactly to fine-tune it to your liking. And of course, there are a few other options here as well, like at least and multiple, which give you even more flexibility. But for most documents, single, 1.5, and double will be all you'll need. Now, before we move on, I want to show you a couple of other handy options in this paragraph dialog box. First, do you notice this checkbox that says don't add space between paragraphs of the same style? This can be really useful if you have specific styles set up in your document and you want to control the spacing more precisely. For example, you might not want any extra space between paragraphs that are both part of a numbered list. Second, take a look at this button down here that says Set as Default. This is a powerful option that allows you to change the default settings for all new documents that you create. So, if you find yourself always adjusting the line spacing or paragraph spacing to the same values, you can set those as your new defaults and save yourself some time in the future. When you click Set as Default, you'll get a pop-up window asking if you want to apply these changes to just the current document or to all new documents that are based on the normal template. If you choose the All Documents option, then every new document you create will use these new spacing settings. This is a great way to customize Word to your own preferences. All right, and now for one quick cleanup tip. If you've been using the Enter key multiple times to create space between paragraphs, like many of us have, there's a quick way to get rid of those extra paragraph breaks and start fresh with our new spacing skills using Find and Replace. I've already made a video previously walking through this process, and I will have it linked in the description of this video for you. And once you've cleaned things up, you can then apply consistent spacing using the spacing settings that we've learned in this video. And the best part is, you will now have complete control over the spacing, and you never have to worry about those pesky extra enter keys ever again. Congratulations! You've now mastered the art of paragraph spacing in Word. Remember, spacing after, spacing before, and line spacing are your keys to creating professional, polished documents with ease. Now go forth and create beautifully formatted documents, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel. And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.